Welcome back to our video series, 3D Printing Myths Explained. If you have missed the last episode, please have a look in the description box. You'll find the link there. Natalie, last week we talked about volatiles and fumes out of 3D printing materials. Is that also the reason why some people dry their materials in the oven before printing? And do I even have to do that?
Good question, and it is definitely related. Last week we talked about the thermogravimetric analysis, TGA, that can be used to detect the volatiles and any fumes that come out of a material. And I also showed a curve, and I'll bring that back up now, where you see a measurement of a TGA, the mass loss as a function of temperature, and in the lower temperature ranges, 100 degrees C and close to that area, we saw a mass loss of 1% in our ABS sample, and that's really attributed to the moisture and humidity it had picked up. And that depends on the material. ABS, as I'm showing here, 1%, that's not a whole lot compared to other polymers. For example, nylons, short PA, which we see more and more coming as 3D printing filament, they have really a much bigger moisture uptake in the range of 3 to sometimes 6%. But ABS on the common materials probably has the biggest, and PLA doesn't. And that is related to the molecular structure. So the more space and the more the molecular structure allows for space, the more water can diffuse into our material. And as we're heating it inside of the 3D printing nozzle, that water evaporates. And as it exits out of the nozzle, that's actually where we have atmospheric pressure. That's where the bubbles burst. And that's what you see on your filament. And in the worst case, a bubble can be big enough that it even stops your material, interrupts your material feed, and then you have a broken filament, in a sense.
So what do I do if I don't have a TGA at home?
Yeah, that's a good question. I assume that is really something for the industrial space. For home users, you have already indicated it. There's a lot of information about drying it in your oven, and that is really something that helps. First of all, when you receive your material, it's vacuum bagged and it has some desiccant in it, so you're safe to use it right out of the packaging. And then for a couple of days, it's probably also good. In the summer, when it's really humid, that duration might be shorter. But overall, it's common sense that you get a feeling for how long you can use your material out of the package. And if it really gets too moist, humid, you see that in the bubbles. And then it's recommended to dry it in your oven. Because an oven at home is really much harder to control the temperature in the lower range, you should do your own tests and see how long it takes for your oven setting to get a dry filament. I would recommend starting with 60 to 70 degrees C and leave it in for 3 to 4 hours. You know that diffusion, so the speed with which the moisture comes out, is temperature dependent. So you can increase the temperature to make that faster, or if it's not sufficient what you see, but you have to take in mind that the spool that your filament is on is also out of plastic, and that normally softens at temperatures much lower than your filament, and you could get warpage, and then it doesn't fit on your printer anymore, and then you haven't really won anything. So play with it and figure out what the best settings are for your oven and your material.
Great, thank you very much. Thank you for watching. We will see you next week talking about print temperatures.